Hi friends, welcome to EduTap. So welcome to the Fast Track series for NABARD Grade 2018 brought to you by EduTap. Now this is a short series where each day we come up with a new lecture where we discuss some of the very important data points and concepts that are very relevant for the upcoming examination. So this is lecture number 29. Let us begin. So basically yesterday we were having a discussion regarding some of the tillage implements. So we discussed four tillage implements. Now moving forward with the same theme, in this particular lecture, let us have a look at three of the tillage implements, and then we shall have a look at what are the classification of fertilizers. Then we should move on to have a look at what are the examples of important biofertilizers, right? So if you see here in this picture, this is an example of rotavator. Okay, and the capacity it has is hectare per hour, it is 0.38 to 0.5. This is important data point. Okay, and the power source is going to be 30 to 65, 37.5 to 48.75. Okay, and you can see the unit is horsepower per kilowatt and it is tractor driven. Okay, it is used as both primary as well as secondary tillage operations. And it is also useful for puddling the field before paddy transplanting. Okay, now you need to just remember the puddling process that we had dealt in detail while we were having a discussion regarding the tillage process that we had seen while discussing in MCQ, 5 MCQs a day lecture. So basically you can see that if the tillage operations are performed in standing water, it is also called wet tillage. Okay, so then it is referred to as puddling. And usually the depth of the standing water is going to be 5 to 10 centimeter. Well, let us just move forward to the next one. So it is cultipacker. You can have a look at the picture out here. And weight is nearly 1350 kg. Power requirement is given 35 by 26.25. It is also tractor driven. Right, and it is used for breaking of clods and packing of soil. Okay, and because of it, it helps in conserving moisture. Okay, so when you say breaking of clods, we are referring to the clumps of soil that usually get formed. Okay, so for breaking that, we use this particular cultipacker. Kindly have a look at power requirement, that is very important. Moving on to post hole digger. Okay, so the field capacity is nearly 12 pits per hour. Obviously, it is used for digging holes for plantation or horticulture crops. And they also are used to dig holes for farm fencing. So these are some of the uses. So obviously, the field capacity is going to be in pits per hour. So it's 12. The power source in horsepower per kilowatt is given. Kindly memorize it. So now we have seen nearly 7 implements. Now it is important that you remember the field capacity and the power source specifically. So kindly make sure that you revise these things before you go to the examination. Now we are having a look at the classification of fertilizers. So in some of our lectures, we had dedicated it specifically to manures. Right, so we know that as we humans require food, plants also do, right? So how do we supply the important nutrients to plants? Through fertilizers and manures, which are applied to the soil, and from the soil the plants take it up through dissolving those things in water, right? Now if you talk about manures, they are basically dead and decomposed plant and animal matter. So basically these are organic in nature. So if you remember, we have discussed elaborately about the basic organic, the manures that are there. They can be bulky organic manures or they can be even concentrated. We had also seen the important examples like farm yield manure, green manure, right? And what was the NPK ratio of those? That was very important. Now coming to fertilizers, they are chemically or industrially synthesized. Okay, and let us see, they also form a very important class of important source of providing nutrients to the plants. Now when you come to classification of fertilizers, you need to know what are the various classification and the basis of what they are classified. The first one, if you see, it is straight fertilizer. Okay, this particular fertilizer would contain or supply only one major nutrient. This is important. Okay, for example, urea, it supplies only nitrogen. So this is a an example of straight fertilizer. When you come to complex fertilizer, it basically supplies two or more primary nutrients. Okay. So again, complex is the name that is given. Then mixed fertilizers are the products made by mixing two or more fertilizers. So when you talk about complex, it is specifically referring to primary. And when you talk about mixed, it is two or more, but it can be any fertilizer, right? Then comes complete fertilizer. So the fertilizer that has all the three primary major nutrients, right? So NPK, all the three, if it is present in a particular fertilizer, then it is referred to as complete. So you can see that complete fertilizer can also be called as a mixed fertilizer. Okay, so it is like the requirement for mixed is what? There should be two or more fertilizers mixed together. Right? So that can be a complete one. But mixed fertilizers cannot be called complex always. Okay, because in sometimes if there are only, there's only one primary nutrient that is present, then obviously you cannot call mixed as complex. Okay, you need to understand that. Then if you talk about low analysis fertilizers, they have less than 25% of the primary nutrient present in it. Okay. And if it is high analysis fertilizer, it is going to contain more than 25% of the total primary nutrient. Example again being urea. So kindly make sure that you know what each of these fertilizers stand for. Next, we have certain examples of important biofertilizers. Now, friends, you need to understand that the amount or the nutrients that are basically required for plants to be taken up, they should be present in such a form that the plants would be able to take them up. Okay. For example, let me just explain it to you. When you talk about nitrogen, mostly nitrogen is present in the organic matter that is present in the soil. Right? Now what happens is, though this organic matter is present in the soil, it is not possible for the plants to take up this organic matter, that is take up the nitrogen from this organic matter as such. No, there are certain microorganisms that decompose this organic matter and break the nitrogen which is present in it into usable form. For example, they convert it into ammonia and forms like nitrates, which can be then taken up by the plants for its growth, right? So what happens is, there are certain microorganisms that are specifically involved in nitrogen fixation process, okay? And the mode through which they perform so, or the various associations that they have is given in this tabular column. So what happens is, usually we take advantage of certain microorganisms, and even we can prepare certain living cells, we can even culture those cells and then apply in the soil so that the process can be repeated in the soil, the same process that happens in the nature or the natural environment. Okay, so now you see the first category is talking about the nitrogen fixing biofertilizers. Okay, so basically they are from the atmosphere, they directly fix nitrogen in the form that can be taken up by the plants. So this category of biofertilizers can be free living, they can be symbiotic, or they can be associative symbiotic. Okay, so when you say free living, they're just found in the soil and they fix the nitrogen from the atmosphere. When you say symbiotic, they have a physical contact with the plant for which it actually fixes nitrogen. When you talk about associative symbiotic, basically what they're doing is they are present in an area which is known as rhizosphere. So when you see a plant, the roots of the plant is in immediate contact with a particular environment of the soil. Okay, so that immediate contact environment is referred to this rhizosphere. Okay, so the organisms that are present in this area of contact with the root in the soil are referred to as associative symbiotic. They are not in direct physical contact, but still they are present in that zone which is near the root. Okay, so now the examples are very important for each of these. For example, you talk about symbiotic relationship, you need to know that Rhizobium, Frankia, Enabena, Azolea, these are all examples of nitrogen fixing biofertilizers in the process of symbiotic relationship, right? Then we also have other list where you can see phosphorus solubilizing biofertilizers. Again, you need to know the examples, at least have an idea, so that even if the question comes, you can pick it up from the answer. Then you have again, that is solubilizing, this is mobilizing, that is the difference, okay. Then you have biofertilizers for micronutrients, again bacillus species plays a major role, kindly note this down. Then you have plant growth promoting rhizose bacteria, that is pseudomonas. Just know the name of it, don't go into the detail right now. Now, one other important examples of these biofertilizers that we had just seen is the symbiotic relationship that exists between the plants and the nitrogen fixing bacteria. So out of this, there is a very famous symbiotic relationship between a water fern, that is Azolla, and a cyanobacterium, that is Enebena azolae. Okay, so we are not going to go into what happens exactly, the mechanism, but just remember these two names. Azolla plus the cyanobacterium, that is Enebena azolae. Okay. Then if you see the other one, it is going to be the symbiotic relationship between actinorhizal trees and shrubs. For example, alder. Okay, it comes under Alnus species. So this alder tree with an actinomycete Frankia. So these two examples, just memorize them. And understand that these are biofertilizers. Okay. So with this, we have come to the end of this particular lecture. So today we had seen three tillage implements. We had a look at the various classification of fertilizers. Kindly revise the manure lectures also before you're doing this fertilizer lecture. Then there was a quick discussion regarding the important biofertilizers, and we saw two important symbiotic relationships that exist. Till then, friends, thank you so much and happy learning.